I've watched it a number of times now, and I'll watch it 1,000 more times by the time we get in there again. And that's the only way you can learn something.
All right, let's go inside the ring now, and ring announcer Ed Darien.
For this evening's main event, we'd once again like to direct your attention to the blue corner, a young man holding the belt right here, right in front of us. He happens to be the brand new World Boxing Association Junior Middleweight Champion, a native of Kingston, Jamaica, and now fighting out of New York, ladies and gentlemen, here is Mike McCallum. McCallum. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. It's scheduled for 10 rounds, and it's in a lightweight division. The judges, Harold Letterman, Tony Castellano, and John Stewart. Counting for the knockdown seconds, alternate referee Frank Cappuccino. The timekeeper to bell is Justin Bucanico. In the ring at this time, the man in charge of the scheduled 10-round lightweight bout, referee Larry Hazard. And now, boxing fans, introducing the principals. First, in the red corner, wearing the red trunks with the white trim. He tipped in at 136.5 pounds. This gentleman has a record of 15 wins, 3 losses, 2 draws with 7 knockouts. A native of Mayagüez, Puerto Rico, and now residing in Brockton, Massachusetts. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Edwin Corret. Corret. And his opponent in the blue corner, wearing the gold trunks with the green and red trim. He weighed in at an even 138 pounds. This young man has a record of 21 wins, 1 loss, 1 draw, with 14 knockouts. A native of St. Croix, the Virgin Islands, and now residing in Passaic, New Jersey, ladies and gentlemen, the World Boxing Association lightweight champion, Livingstone Kid Brembo. Brembo.
Okay, you gentlemen are both familiar with the rules of the New Jersey State Athletic Commission because you fought here before. Let me remind you that I expect you to conduct yourselves in a spirit of good sportsmanship at all times. Also, I cannot and will not accept any intoleration of the rules. You have any questions? Okay, shake hands now. Come out fighting at the bell.
And a tail of the tape. Curette, 5'7", 136 and a half, 70-inch reach. And Bramble, 5'8", 138, and a 4-inch reach advantage. Curette with the fight of his life on his left, and Livingstone Bramble on the right. 10 rounds. It is a non-title fight. Al Albert along with Randy Gordon and the ex-WBA lightweight champion, Ray Boom Boom Mancini.
That didn't sit well with me, Al.
That hurt.
All right, what are you looking for now as you watch this fight, as you take a close look at Livingstone Bramble?
No, he's fighting the same fight he usually fights. He's a patient fighter, kind of deliberate at times. You know, he has that long reach, and he has them long arms. He keeps his elbows in tight. You know, right now it's a non-title fight. He has everything to lose, you know, in this fight, so he should be patient and take his time and let Curette make the mistakes, which I believe he's doing. There's a fine line. You want the guy to make the mistakes, but you don't want to let him take the fight away from you either, you know, and get off first.
Well, manager Lou Duva of Livingstone Bramble said that if you want to learn how to fight, don't watch Bramble.
It's so true, because you never know what the guy's going to do next. Ray against you, so many times, he'd start switching up right-hander, southpaw. Did it confuse you?
Nah, we had a southpaw that came with me all 6 weeks. I was ready for that. I knew what he was going to do. People trying to make too much of something.
Well, if he switches to southpaw tonight on Curette, Curette's last fight against Robin Blake, and he had Blake down in the fifth round before Blake came back to win the decision. Curette, 15-3-2 with 7 knockouts, now fighting out of Brockton, Massachusetts, the stable of Marvis Marvelous Marvin Hagler, Pat Goody Petronelli handling Curet. And a rocky script has been set up for him. He is unranked and now going up against the champion. He knows that if he should pull off the big upset now, not only will he wreck the plans of the Boom Boom Mancini and Livingstone Bramble for a rematch in January, he will probably get the title fight against Bramble.
Ray, I remember in the dressing room after you lost to Bramble, Hector Camacho, they're talking about you and the Macho Man. He came over and gave you a hug, and he said, don't worry about it.
Yeah, you know, we're professional athletes, and again, you know, people try to make something. Sure, you know, there's a lot of hype going on, but hype is getting old. And, you know, when he was in the locker room, he consoled me because, you know, we are fighters. It wasn't consoling Ray Mancini, so to speak. It was consoling a fighter that could have been any one of us. It could have been him that night. Could have been any one of us. So, you know, I chose that. You know, I really got a lot of respect for him for that, a whole new outlook on him.
Round number two, scheduled for 10. Livingstone Bramble in the gold. Edwin Curet in the red.
Notice that Livingstone Bramble has come out as a southpaw.
Randy, a lot of people said, oh, that must have confused Mancini. And if you watch the fight, like I have many times, but they ain't going to remember it. But when he switched to southpaws, when I ripped him with right hands more times than any of us, you know, during the fight, it was the best shot I hit him with the straight right hands when he turned southpaw. And everybody's talking about how it confused me.
When Al and I are always sitting here, we're always talking about a fighter can learn from a loss. Do you think you really learned from that loss?
Everybody learns from every, you know, wins and losses. Sure, you have to learn. If you don't, then you're not, you know, too bright. I'm saying this, in life, you know, life's experiences will teach you if you let them. And sure, I learned from the loss.
Well, one thing Ray Mancini gave Livingstone Bramble was a forum, because the world found out about the eccentricity of Livingstone Bramble. He's the second champion now out of the Virgin Islands. The other one, Emil Griffith. And Bramble, with his now celebrated animal collection, his three pet snakes, including a 5.5-foot boa constrictor, a 7-foot python, 5 pit bull terriers. And to tell you a little bit about Bramble, just like his personality, how he fights, here's a guy who has a snake named Dog and a dog named Snake. He is a vegetarian, hasn't eaten meat since the age of 9, and he prepares for his fights with menus consisting of coconut, pumpkin, and yams, and fish and spaghetti. And now, putting in the solid shot in the stomach of Edwin Curet. Al Albert with Ray Boom Boom Mancini and Randy Gordon at ringside at Harry's, watching this 10-round non-title fight, with Mancini extremely interested in Livingstone Bramble as they look to set up a date for a rematch in January. How is that coming, Ray?
Well, that really depends on tonight's fight. Things are going well, but that's up to my man, living up to him. I'm not really getting involved with negotiations. I know where everything stands now, and really I'll know where a lot more stands after this fight.
15 seconds to go in the second round. And a low blow that puts Bramble to the canvas. Now pointing at Curet. This coming at the end of the second round, Larry Hazard asking if Bramble is okay. Bramble, an incredibly conditioned athlete, but conditioning can go so far. Bramble given the time to shake it off. Edwin Curet with just seconds remaining in the second round. And Bramble retaliates.
Out for for a day just chasing the sun or doing the work that's got to be done or riding a race that's got to be won. Kawasaki. Now with a choice of three-wheelers that offer low prices, high performance, and about everything in between. And for one more wheel of a time, check out the all-new Bayou four-wheeler. Get the best of both worlds at your Kawasaki dealer.
Round number three, interesting conclusion to round number two. Edwin Curet going low on Bramble, doubling him over in the final seconds of the second round. So Bramble, figuring with just seconds remaining, would retaliate. And went low on Curet.
And it was interesting what referee Larry Hazard had to say, because at the end of round number two, he went over to Bramble and said, okay, you got him back, now let's calm down.
Very unorthodox style of boxing, the Livingstone Bramble. But Lou Duva says, with all the minuses as far as the style is concerned, there are certainly pluses that far outweigh the minuses. As Larry Hazard again stepping in, talking about Bramble's strength, his animal-like instincts, rising to the occasion, and also the fact that he can take a punch, which was demonstrated in the fight with Ray Mancini. Duva felt that in that fight, his fighter took quite a bit of punches, but he doesn't show it. He doesn't cut. He doesn't go down.
Well, we all thought that about Duran, too, though, didn't we?
Ray, there's a lot of people who feel that, let's compare George Foreman, and we'll wait to compare that.
And here is Bramble closing in. And tackling Dura.
At the end of the second round, when Bramble got hit low, Ray, I got to ask you, do you think it really got him incensed? Do you think he really wants to punish Curet now?
I really think it got him a little motivated, maybe. But people don't understand. You don't let personal feelings get involved. It's a job in there. If you like him or if you don't like him, it's a job, and you just have to do your job like a workman.
No, but if a guy thumbs you or hits you low, don't you want to get him back instantly?
Sure, but also a lot of guys do that to get your mind off track, to get your mind off your fight plan. So you kind of have to let it go by. It sure motivates you, though, to come back and let this guy know that he can't get away with that stuff, though. You know, Curet's almost as unorthodox as Bramble was at times.
Sometimes you think he's going to do one thing and he does
exactly
the other.
Exactly.
25 seconds in the third round. This is scheduled for 10.
Get it.
Round number four, you may ask, with a rematch hanging in the balance in January between Ray Mancini and Livingstone Bramble, why is Bramble now going out and perhaps risking it all in a non-title fight? Well, first of all, they were unable to line up a title fight now for Bramble before January, before Boom Boom. And Lou Duva likes to keep his fighter in the gym. Says this is a trade. Keep them in the factory, keep them in shape, keep their weight at a decent level. Plus, he feels that Bramble needs the challenge, that he rises to the occasion. And tonight, they've instilled into Bramble that he is not actually fighting an Edwin Curet, but tonight he is fighting not to lose the Ray Mancini fight. And I'm sure as Ray looks on here with us at ringside, he is also hoping not to lose the Livingstone Bramble fight.
Right.
Ray, a question I was going to get to earlier is that so many people say if you look at the George Foreman fights against Joe Frazier, they say if they fought 10 times in a row, Frazier would win every fight. A lot of people think, and Bramble's one of those people, that you have a style that is absolutely made for him. He says, every time we fight, I win. What do you...
Well, there's just...
Of course, they're going to say no, but...
No, still, and there's on the other hand, a lot of people think that Bramble's win was a fluke and think that I'll hand him his behind the next time, which I am one of. So, you know, what are you going to do?
Midway mark in round number four. Livingstone Bramble in the gold. Edwin Curette in the red. Curette is unranked. And certainly has the opportunity of his life. Ray, if you could get into the corner with Edwin Curette, what would you tell him?
Don't come out for the next round. No, but you know, I'm watching the fight. Edwin Curette's best work is when he's on the inside. He's out fighting Bramble on the inside, but then he pulls out.
Well, Curette, a mobile fighter. Bramble initially looking to bang the body, try to limit Curette's mobility, and then try to pick him apart.
Unfortunately for Edwin Curette, I mean, he's got fast hands, but he does not have that Ray Boom Boom Mancini power. Those are arm punches, and there's really nothing behind him.
And there is Bramble going. The combination to the head. It was a slip, was it? Yes, says Larry Hazard. A slip, not a knockdown. With 12 seconds left in the fourth round. For our local systems, let's pause now for these messages. Round number five, it's scheduled for 10, non-title fight. WBA lightweight champion, Livingstone Bramble in the gold, Edwin Curette in the red. Bramble, a record of 21-1-1 with 14 knockouts. His lone loss came at the hands of Anthony Fletcher back in 1981. Lost an 8-round decision. His only, the draw to Bruce Williams in his second fight. The draw in 4 rounds.
Ray, a question I've been meaning to ask you. When you came up to my office a few weeks ago for the photo session, I forgot to ask you, did it take your mind off the fight when you were fighting Bramble in the weeks that were leading up to the fight when he announced he had a witch doctor?
No.
And they made a big thing out of it?
Really, I'm a Christian. I'm a Catholic Christian. My faith is in the God and the Lord. He can bring whatever he wants and they don't mean nothing. You know, they try to make something out of that, and that's ridiculous.
I mean, they really tried all the hype they could.
Hey, he could have Dr. Duda's court. I got Father O'Neill on mine. That's it. It's all I need.
And it turned out the witch doctor was really his old basketball coach.
Yeah. His first name was Dog.
Yeah.
Al Albert ringside with Ray Boom Boom Mancini and Randy Gordon watching Livingstone Bramble, who in June upset Boom Boom to take the title. And now the two looking forward to getting together again in January. But right now, it is Bramble in this non-title fight, and he knows he has to get by that. Edwin Curette, who is looking for the win of his career, which would set up a championship fight between he and Bramble. But right now, Bramble looks to be in total command. Curette willing to trade punches with Bramble. See Bramble closing in with his fight face on.
And he's also talking to Curette, really wants to give him a beating.
I'll tell you what, Edwin Curette's showing a lot of guts to fighting, though. A lot of people have criticized Edwin Curette for not having the heart that he should have, but he's showing it here today.
He really is showing a lot of courage. Bramble is talking up a storm to him. I mean, just about reciting passages.
And now Curette holding on.
Right. When you got things going your way, I don't give too much credibility. When you got things going your way, yeah, it's easy to talk. Talk when you're backing up. That'll impress me.
Things getting very interested here in the fifth round. Livingstone Bramble with some ice now being applied to his forehead. Here at ringside, Ray Boom Boom Mancini is joining us to watch the fight, watch the fighter that dethroned him, the fighter he wants again. Now in the fifth round, he was talking to Curette. What do you think he was hollering at him? Did he do much talking with you?
No, he didn't do a lot of talking with me. He did some clowning around the dirt and jabbing around, and people thought, no, like I said, when you got things going your way, it's very easy to do that. That doesn't impress me. Like I said, do it when you got your back to the wall. But, hey, that's his way. You know, if it maybe it pumps him up or motivates him, I don't know.
Just hearing some of the comments you've made here through the first five rounds, would I be correct in saying that the Livingstone Bramble's name is not on your Christmas card list?
Oh, no, I like the guy. No, no, don't let no new kids in. I miss him, I do. That's why I can't wait to get in there in January. Spend more time with him.
It is six-round action. Ray, do you think Curette threw what he had there in the fifth round, looking to haul off and perhaps come up with the stunner?
Well, I'll tell you, if I was Bramble, I would think that was Curette's best. You know, and I would go out and try to take him out like it looks like he's doing now. But, you know, you can't get careless in there. Curette is one of these guys as unorthodox as Bramble is, like I said, and he may come throw something from the floor, and you just say he might run into something.
Randy, you know how well-conditioned Livingstone Bramble is. He has been training up in Grossinger's with Lou Duva's Olympic stars, Breland, Holyfield, Biggs, Taylor is up there, Whitaker. And they say that Bramble has been like the Marine drill sergeant, taking them through all the conditioning.
Oh yeah, those guys are used to some amateur training. He's really putting them through some strenuous workout. Bramble is one of those athletes, I have to put him in a class with Marvelous Marvin Hagler and Ray Boom Boom Mancini. When they train, I mean, they train.
Sixth round action is scheduled for 10.
Ray, when you get in the ring with Bramble again, not that your stay is going to matter or anything, but would you prefer a smaller ring or a bigger ring? Because I think you guys are going to wail away anyway.
Well, that's right. Last time we fought, it was a, 18-foot ring. And, you know, it didn't matter. And it won't matter every time we fight, like I said. I'll just tell you one thing. When we do meet again, it won't go to distance. One of us will go. I promise you that. And I don't plan on beating me this time. I went through that route already.
Is it too early for you to plan strategy for that fight?
No, you know, being in there with them already, I don't have to change my style of fighting or the technique I'm going to fight them. We know what we're going to do. We're just going to improve on what we did. And we're going to be physically up to this fight. We weren't last time, and we're going to be physically right. And when I'm physically right, I lick this kid. In my heart and my mind, that's what I believe.
30 seconds to go. In what way don't you feel you're up to par physically?
Oh, no, no. Well, anybody who knows Randy, and I'm sure you've heard the term about leaving it in the gym. And we did. And that's no excuse. That's just fact. And that's not nobody's fault but our own. But next time, we'll correct that mistake.
And Livingstone Bramble in the gold, Edwin Curette in the red, and Goody Petronelli in the corner of Curette telling him that he's driving Bramble crazy.
What do you think, Ray? Is he driving him crazy?
Well,
because he's going nuts missing you. Do you see it that way?
Well, first of all, I don't see it that way, no. Like I said, Bramble's a very disciplined fighter, and I don't think he's getting unraveled by what Curette's doing. But it's the right thing that Goody Petronelli's telling this fighter. Get him motivated, you know, give him some sort of hope that he can take this fight.
Well, after six rounds, Randy Gordon has given two rounds to Curette and four rounds to Bramble. You see it the same way?
Yeah, they're very close rounds, but I see Bramble taking it. You know, he is the champ. He's coming forward, backing the other guy up, and he's landing more of the blows and more solid blows.
Co-manager Goody Petronelli in the corner was telling Edwin, come on, let's get some kick on those punches. More kick. I don't know if he can.
Ray, when you heard of this fight, how do you expect it to go? When you heard of this fight, this matchup, how did you expect it to go?
Well, I'll tell you what, again, I know Curet is a strong fighter. Physically, he's a strong man, and he's an awkward fighter. But I felt Bramble would beat him because he has more, if you could say this, he's more unorthodox than the other guy. But like I said, a lot of people question Curet's heart at times. And I didn't know if that would be a factor in this fight, but it doesn't seem to be right now. It just seems like he's outgunned right now.
Well, this is Curet's moment, and he knows that. Comes in with a record of 15 wins, 3 losses, 2 draws, 7 knockouts. His last fight in July, he knocked down Robin Blake before losing in 10 rounds.
Ray, would it be giving away any big secrets if I asked you, in fight number 2 in the rematch, will you concentrate more on the body?
That's a big secret, Randy.
And the exchange is here. Bramble now getting the best of it as Jarrett tries to hold on. Jarrett has been willing to exchange with Bramble.
What I think is getting Bramble confused is he is missing this guy with shots, and this guy's hitting him with shots that he shouldn't be getting hit with. So it's a little confusing for him.
Curet just laid out a lazy left hand. He's lucky Bramble didn't fire a right-hand counter.
Final seconds of the 7th. Well, in the corner of Edwin Curet, Goody Petronelli, either just encouraging words but feel that they perhaps could have a shot. Feel that Bramble is getting somewhat careless and said, well, he may be looking past you, looking right towards the guy sitting with us right here, Ray Boom Boom Mancini. Do you think Curet has any shot?
Well, hey, everybody's got a shot. There's 2 rounds left, and you know, what did Yogi Berra you say? It's not over till it's over, right? So, to use his line, that's true. Edwin Curet's in there throwing punches. He's throwing good punches. He's hitting the man often. He's hitting him hard. So I'm just holding my breath until that final bell rings.
Well, if Curet has success against Bramble here, not if, you know, even if he in defeat, you think you may change your style to become a little more unorthodox?
No. No. We, like I said, in our fight, that's the most important fight of my life, and somebody will go that night. I won't be fighting like Curet, like I was forced to fight last time.
Ah, you can lie to us and tell us you're going to switch to southpaw. That would be a newsmaker.
Well.
Edwin Curet has lost only 3 fights in his career, 3 of them to world-class fighters, Tyrone Crawley, Robin Blake, and a guy that one of your best friends put him in a class with Livingston Bramble, Kenny Bang Bang Bogdan.
Oh, yeah. He's on my Christmas list, too, Al. I'm gonna send him a paycheck since he missed 2 in our fights.
Midway through the 8th round, Livingston Bramble, freshly crowned champion in a non-title fight, looking to tune up for a January date. That's after Christmas when he and Boom Boom get together with Mancini for the title again.
I tell you, the one punch that I've watched Curet throw that I may try to use against Bramble is the one he threw in the 1st round that sent Bramble down.
That was the low blow.
Yeah, well, whatever.
Well, certainly was effective.
It's effective, I was just going to say.
And Bramble back to southpaw again. He's been taking a lot of shots this round.
Yeah, the one punch Curet is hitting Bramble with is a punch that Rafael Williams was successful with, and that's that uppercut right between his guard. It was a punch I tried to throw, not successfully though.
Rafael Williams went the distance in a losing effort against Bramble last January 22nd underneath the Johnny Bumpus title card when he won the WBA Junior Welterweight Championship.
Final seconds of the 8th round.
Watch the head. Watch the head.
So that is the end of 8 rounds. Livingston Bramble Goes into the corner with Lou Duva. What do you think Lou Duva is thinking of right now? It's a non-title fight.
He can't do nothing, right?
Yeah, let's listen in.
You got to keep backing him up, and you got to keep going with two hands. You don't go with no single shots.
Right?
Don't wait too long with this guy. Get your combinations all over. You do the fast punching.
Walking a little bit more pressure, a little more body pressure.
Well, perhaps some thought that it would be over now. Lou Duva talks about the conditioning of Bramble, knowing that his fighter is getting a workout in a tune-up.
Was it ninth round?
Ninth round.
Well, you got to hustle this guy. You hear?
All right, here's eighth round action. Randy and Ray, take a look.
You and Jay, baby?
Well, Edwin, I think, is spending a little too much time with his back to the ropes, but I thought it was a good round for him. He landed a lot of shots. I gave him the round. I've got it unofficially 5-3 for Livingston Bramble.
That sounds about right.
And Lou Duva, extremely upset at Livingston Bramble, yelling to him, get down over there, as Bramble very slowly stepping out of his corner.
Maybe he feels Bramble's taking this a little too nonchalant.
And he wants Bramble to stop throwing one punch at a time. He wants him to start putting the punches together, backing Curette up.
Well, as hard as this may be, I have to support Bramble on this fact that Curette is in and out. He's not the easiest guy to hit tonight. He's hitting, he's moving in, he's backing out. He's showing me that he knows a lot of the tricks. He's giving him the shoulder. He walks away from him. He's a pretty cute fighter, this Edwin Curette is.
There's a right by Curette.
And you have to wonder, if that was a Mancini right hand, would Bramble still be standing there?
Well, I'd like to think not.
What happens when you hit a guy with your best shot? Al and I go through this so many times. When you hit a guy your best shot right in the mouth, and he looks at you.
Well, Randy, you can't get discouraged, because a lot of guys, you hit one shot, and they won't go. But that if you hit him a couple more times, they eventually go. It's like chopping a tree. You hit it, you know, you got to chop away at it. And them shots rattle a guy. Don't let nobody kid you about that.
And I know those body shots you land can stay with a guy.
Well, on your guys' cards, if Curette wins this round, Ray, will your heart be pounding through the 10th?
Well, I tell you, there's no need to worry, and I'm just going to see what happens as the fight goes. I'd like to have confidence that everything's going to work out right. And
it's okay, Ray. You can sit here and we understand.
I don't know what else to say. I mean, if Curette keeps fighting like this in the middle of the 10th, I might jump in and pull him back. I don't know.
In a situation like this for Bramble, looking ahead, and this is a tune-up, non-title fight, do you think he is thinking of you?
Well, you know, a lot of people ask me if I was thinking ahead past Livingston Bramble. And I kept saying no. In all honesty, no, I wasn't. Bramble was the guy I was concentrating on, but because of human nature, you can't help but think of the other opponents. And I'm just saying, Livingston Bramble, I'm sure he can't help but think of our rematch. But right now, he has Edwin Curette in front of him, and I'm sure he's concentrating on the job right now, especially when the guy's tattooing him.
Randy, what does this do for Edwin Curette?
Good shot right there.
Well, this has got to increase his stock. A lot of guys are going to want to fight him. You know, they think he's going to be an easy target, a good workout. But really, this guy is a tough, world-class fighter.
He just got hit with a tremendous right hand earlier, about 30 seconds ago, and I think it's got him hurt.
Final seconds of the ninth. So that is the end of the ninth round. Livingston Bramble coming to his corner with a glance at Ray Boom Boom Mancini sitting here at ringside. Bramble on the right, Curette on the left. And we go to a 10th and final round.
Well, we said at the top of the show that Edwin Curette was in real great shape. He's got Pat and Goody Petronelli working him all the time, working him hard. And here we are, the 10th and final round.
As Bramble looked over here, Ray, was that a little wink you gave him?
Oh, shit, I nodged to him, you know.
Wasn't a kiss.
All right, let's listen in. This is Bramble's corner. Round action. action. The crowd here in Atlantic City.
You hear what they're yelling, boom, boom.
Buy the men a drink back there.
Because the Dubas have a lot of their people here tonight, and they know that a victory for Bramble will bring on boom, boom.
The left by Bramble.
I think Edwin Trent just made one vital mistake. He showed Livingstone Bramble he was hurt. You know, he shook his head, and he's complaining that he got thumped. Maybe that's why he was shaking his head and blinking.
Could very well be. You know how painful that is.
Yes.
But sometimes you got to grit your teeth. Larry Hauser didn't want to hear any part about it. He said, keep fighting. And Curette landed a low right hand. Bramble this time didn't pay any attention to it.
Well, if Bramble looking for a tune-up, he was looking for a workout. He has gotten it here tonight from Edwin Curette. Curette with hardly the firepower of Boom Boom Mancini fighting here into the 10th round.
Well, it's been all night long for Livingstone Bramble having to chase down Curette, and I think it's safe to say, Ray, against you, he's not going to have to look for you.
No, I'll be there. Curette is he's ready to go. Ready to go. It's a shame for his fight. Tremendous fight. I hope he makes it.
What do you do when a guy cranks his right arm up like that?
Well, Bramble do that against me. And like I said, he does that at the most opportune times. That don't impress me. It doesn't do nothing. You know, you should really be a good champion, a humble champion. He's got to get hurt. Just fight a good fight and win the fight.
Sugar Ray Leonard once told me, when a guy does that to you, you punch him in the mouth.
Well, sure.
Bramble says, come here. Curette says, you come here. 40 seconds left in the 10th. There have been no knockdowns in this fight.
Now listen, when this fight is over, we're going to try to bring Bramble down. I think you should leave because I got a new sport jacket and I don't want to get anything messed up here.
Yeah. We'll have enough time to talk to each other and spend more time when we get together.
And a flurry for Bramble in the closing seconds. 10 seconds to go.
I'd like to see Curette make it. I really do.
And he's holding on.
Looks like he'll do it.
He will do it. And the crowd responding. Here at Harris, Lou Duva even going over to Edwin Curette with Goody Petronelli attending to him. Curette goes the distance, 10 rounds with the WBA lightweight champion, Livingstone Bramble, a non-title fight. And he goes the distance with Edwin Curette. Some hearts perhaps pounding somewhat throughout, although Randy Gordon has Livingstone Bramble winning it, although giving several rounds to Curette. Taking a look, final round action.
Well, Bramble was going out for that knockout, really wanted to impress everybody, especially Ray Mancini. He came out throwing and throwing. Everybody's heart, though, went out to Edwin Curette. He really hung in there, didn't he, Ray?
Yes, he did. Yes, he did.
Bramble just kept chucking. He went southpaw, right-handed. Both hands he threw at Curette, who just took it, suffered a small cut under his right eye, but he hung up, and now Bramble's pointing to you, pointing down at you. Oh, I want you, he said.
Well, what is he going to do? He's just playing up for the crowd.
He likes you so much. The two of you guys, I could tell that friendship, that aura between
you. Oh, yeah, I like the guy, like I really do. And I'm really looking for it. Like I said before, I'm looking forward to spending more time with him. I miss him. And you know, all the bad things he said about me, don't believe that. That just shows how much he likes me. That's his way of showing it.
Maybe he'll let you hold one of his snakes. Ray Boom Boom Mancini, ringside, watching on, looking at hopefully his next opponent.
Let it go, Edwin!
Livingstone Bramble. As Bramble going 10 rounds here in a non-title affair with Edwin Curette, who no way can come out the loser in this confrontation. As we'll await the decision, Randy Gordon had it 7-3 Bramble.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner by unanimous decision, the world.
Decision. Livingstone Bramble, the winner. And as we talk here right now in the camera right underneath the Bramble corner, it is Livingstone Bramble hanging over the ring.
Yeah, well. Yeah, see, you can't wait to husband give me a kid.
Well, what lessons did you learn from viewing tonight?
Nothing.
Tell you anything?
No, nothing that I didn't already know. Yeah, I'm glad to see he got to work in, and I'm glad to see that he's ready. Make it all the see when you know this is Rocky II all over, and it's the real life Rocky. I mean Rocky III. I'm sorry. And when we lick this kid, get the title back, it's gonna be a hell of a win.
I could tell, you know, you could just sense it over and over again how, you know, he.